This is where conviction sets in, when you realize you're in a position that you don't deserve.
There you go.
Say it well.
When you have a life where you're breathing and you know you should be dead.
Yeah.
When you're free, you know you should be in jail. I know you wouldn't want that. The problem is that you have condemned yourself, number one. And then number two, you've told yourself that I can fix myself so that God will be pleased. Okay. You've already lost and the enemy's already won. Everybody with me?
There you go.
And can I be honest? You even gotta wait to get to church, because that's real foolhardy to think that you have enough time.
Right. Come on.
The old saints used to say, tomorrow.
Ain't promised.
When life takes you to a point where you feel like there's nothing you can do to fix it, Jesus is waiting. Hear me. He is waiting for you. Watch this. Because he's been dying to represent you.
Oh my God.
You have two people now who know the system. Here's the difference. The enemy don't know what Jesus knows. The enemy only knows your past, but Jesus knows your future. My uncle used to drink this drink called Tab. Ugh. Yeah. Oh, no. Yeah, you never heard of Tab? Go back to the 80s. Look, they still sell it. I don't know who still drinks it. The worst possible soda you could drink, void of all flavor, okay? I said, man, I said, this trash. He goes, that's not trash. He goes, come here, let me show you something. And he points me to an inscription on the thing. It says, back, I was in California, it says CA redemption value. 5 cents. Okay. In his mind, what you were getting ready to throw away still had value to him.
Yeah.
Oh, come on.
He can still get something out of it if he kept it and gave it to the right people.
Mm-hmm.
Now, mind you, the cans didn't look like this.
Smash on.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. The still same value.
Still same value.
But it's still same value.
The value of the can don't change because it's been crushed.
Yeah. Oh, Jesus. My God.
It doesn't change because it's been ruined. Why?
Oh, Jesus.
Because it's still got.
Because it still has redemption. Do you want to know why God won't throw you away? I know you feel just like this can, and a lot of this was self-inflicted. Didn't nobody do this to you. A lot of this stuff was just bad decisions. And the Lord says, when I look at the top, I see my name and the redemption value. It's not 5 cents, but the cost of his son. He goes, I'll give my son up to have this again. Now, what? Let me go a little step further. The idea is this. This is not going to make another can. It's going to make more cans. This one thing can turn into many things if it's willing to be crushed. Come on. Why won't you help me? If you get into a position where God can crush you, you want more of you. Hear what I'm saying? Real discipleship only comes from people who've been crushed by God. This was on purpose that this happens to you. I know you don't like the way it feels now, but if you can get into a position to go back to the maker. The scripture says it like this. He goes, let's go down to the potter's house. So he can make it again anew. He goes, I don't throw away the clay. I just remold it into what I want to see.
Yeah.
Listen, he sees a six pack out of your one can.